Good morning. Happy Thanksgiving.
I don't like being stared at.
I wasn't. Your burns are healing.
Yeah, that's good to know. Not that I could tell.
Have you done your exercises?
It's Thanksgiving. Everybody gets a day off, even me.
I know, but the more you do them, the sooner things will get back to...
Normal?
New normal. You should do them. Anyway, I just came up here to tell you that my mom's doing dinner early so I can take the kids over to the farm for dessert. I'd love it if you came.
What are you gonna do, Luke? You gonna feed me at the dinner table in front of your whole family? Play airplane with my turkey?
Noah, you have to get out there and do things. Your therapist said that...
I know what she said. I don't want to be the blind guy at the dinner table that everybody's staring at but pretending not to, but just can't help themselves because a train wreck is so damn fascinating.
They wouldn't feel that way, and you know it.
I would. I feel that way. Just go. Be with your family. Have fun. I'll be fine.
How's Noah?
He's refusing to do his physical therapy because it's a holiday.
That's not good. The therapist said that he needed to do it every day.
I know. I tried to tell them that. I was thinking that maybe you might have a little more luck with him.
I'll try. I mean, it's a lot for him to get used to. For all of us.
Look, Mom, I really don't mean to upset you or Damien, but I was thinking that maybe I could take the kids to the farm early.
Before dinner?
Well, all the cousins are there. And they'll get to see the squash get cut just like every year. I think these kids need a dose of normal, even if it's just for today. And by next year, things will be easier. They'll be used to splitting their time between you and Dad.
You think it's selfish of me to want to have my family around me for Thanksgiving?
No! No, but Mom, that's not Thanksgiving. That's catering. Look, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to offend you.
No, you didn't, Luke. You're right.
Mom. I know you and Damien are trying to prove to Dad that you can be good parents, but I just don't think that today's the day.
Hey. What's going on?
It's just gonna be the two of us for Thanksgiving.
Oh, leave it. The kids can finish when I get home. We can use them next year.
We don't need place cards, it's just the two of us. We could have our dinner right here.
If that will make you happy.
We have way too much food.
I love leftovers.
Please stop trying to make it okay. I love Thanksgiving because it's about being with your family, and my kids would rather be with their father, and my mother had a better option, so no offense, but at this point, I'd really just like to skip the whole thing. I'm sorry. I'm really missing my kids right now.
Then you should be with them. Go to the farm. I'll understand.
Only if you go with me.
I'm back.
I can hear you pull up.
My grandma made up a plate for you. Actually, it's enough for three people. And there is dessert downstairs for later.
I'm not hungry.
That's bull. You've barely eaten for the last couple days. You just don't want to take it from me.
You're supposed to be my boyfriend, not my nurse.
Noah, get over it. This is the way things are right now. I'm going to take care of you, and if you want to hate me for it, that's fine. But I'm still going to help you because that's what people who love each other do. Now let me know when you want to eat.
Is that Emma's sweet potatoes I smell?
Yeah. She remembers how much you love them.
Well, now you're just not playing fair.
So your fork is on the left, and your knife is on the right. And this is Grandma's homemade cider.
Could you not hover while I eat it? Makes you uncomfortable.
Okay. I'll go. But, I just wanted to say, I don't know if you remember what we did last year at the farm. Before we eat, everybody says, you know, what they're thankful for.
I remember.
Yeah, and you don't have to say anything, but I just want to say that, after the accident, I wasn't sure that you were going to make it. When I saw you lying there, it wasn't like you were sleeping. It was like I couldn't tell if you were in there. And I was terrified that I had lost you forever. And I know you're suffering. And I would do anything to take that pain away. But I am so thankful that you're here, Noah. I am so thankful for every day that you are in my life.
Oh, sorry, that was me.
It's been quite a year, not just here in Oakdale, but for a lot of people. Tough times for everybody. And maybe that's why it takes the perspective of a guy who was dead and gone to recognize everything that we have to be grateful for. Family, friends, the people we love, who never stop loving us back, no matter what. And the faith that gets us through the dark times.
Luke?
Yeah, I'm right here.
Do you think you'd mind, bringing me seconds?
Thank you for the hope that we cling to. The hope that next year will be better than this one. That tomorrow is going to be a good day for all of us. Thank you for the traditions that bring us together, for the memories that never leave us.
That's one of our favorites.
We make mistakes, people get hurt, so we give thanks for forgiveness and for second chances. We're thankful for the bonds of family that never break. No matter how far we bend them.
Hey! What are you doing here?
I brought you some food. I thought you might want some company.
What do you got?
We'll give thanks for our lost traveler, who's finally back home, where he belongs.
Yes.
We're also painfully aware that not everyone is so lucky. We lost someone very dear to us this year. But we're thankful that he will live on in the hearts of our children and his brother. And for that, and for this tremendous bounty, we are thankful and we say
amen.
Amen.
Oh, happy, 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 happy Thanksgiving, everyone. Okay, come on, let's eat before it gets cold.
Okay, let's eat.
Oh, pass that stuffing over here. Oh,